Hello everyone, so basically today I'm going to be doing a bit of marbling, which is something I've been doing for a uni project. I've been transforming it into screen prints, but today I'm just going to be doing some direct marbling. So I filled up my tray, which is just a normal baking tray. You can use basically whatever you can fit your paper in, because I'm just doing some really cute small tags. Is it going to focus? Nope. Anyway, I'm doing small tags, so all of them will happily fit in the tray. So I have some really nice marbling inks, which again aren't going to focus, but there you go. Maybe it'll focus now, not sure. Anyway, I've got a nice set of those, so all different colours, so I'm just going to experiment, see what's going to work. So to start with, like I said, you need a tray and fill it up with water, just probably a few millimetres in there, enough to colour the cover the bottom, and then just drop some of your ink in. It comes in a little pot, should have a dropper in there, so you don't need to do too much. Just drop a few in and your pattern will start to form already on the water surface. And then you can dip your tag in. And you can repeat this until the water kind of gets really dirty, and then it won't really be suitable to use anymore, and you'll just have to kind of give it a bit of a wash out and replace it with some different water. And if you change colour, then also you'll have to change the water, unless you want to have a mix of two colours, which can be quite nice. Now with the black paper, it's not working too well. I'm not sure if you can see there, the ink's not really staying on it, so I think we'll see how it looks with a red. Now that looks really nice. So I've had a go with the white now. So now I'm going to have a bit of experiment with some silver. And the silver has been slightly problematic in the past, so I'm not totally sure how this one's going to go. But I'll definitely be interested, because silver on black would look really nice. So I think we'll just have to persevere with this one and see how it turns out. Maybe you could mix it with another colour. But yeah, just give it a go. It looks lovely in the water, so I'll zoom in so you can see it in a minute. What I really love about the marbling is the beautiful patterns that just are made purely randomly. It's just definitely something that you don't get with any other sort of experimental art form. So let's see how it goes. Oh, it's taken very well to the blue. You can see that there. Let's try the brown now. Oh, that looks lovely. I'm very keen to use brown tags. I've just got a feeling that that will work well with my project. So I'm experimenting on that mainly. But I'll have a go with all the colours. So. Black and silver. Let's try a bit of a basic white one as well. Not quite so exciting or interesting. So this time you have a proper live view, totally in on the action. I think I might go for black, which is something I've not tried before, because usually I like to have a bit of colour in my designs, so see how this goes. As you can see, the blobs come out quite well. Unlike the other ones, the black seems to be much more liquidy, so I'm gonna tilt the tray a bit and see if we can get any unusual swirls to appear. Oh, see, now I've got some nice patterns which will come out on the tags. And I'll just dip that in, take it with your fingers, and don't submerge it totally, just kind of gently keep a hold of it. And there you go, you can see, lovely little pattern there. Let's try with some other ones, see what we can get. A brown tag again. That looks very nice. Even just half printed looks something quite extraordinary. I wonder how black on black will look. Perhaps we'll see more when it dries. Sometimes just having a chance to try things out, especially with something that's really turns out different every single time, anyway, I hope you've enjoyed this kind of how-to video. If you'd like me to do anything more or film videos as I go along, do let me know. Anyway, thanks for watching.